both times this side scored three goals. Well, I guess Atalanta, they came back, scored a couple. That is the same Atalanta that defeated Napoli at the weekend. They put a huge dent in their confidence, and perhaps more. Supporting Neto, you can see Chiellini back in the starting lineup, wearing the captain's armband. He's supported alongside Bonucci and Barzagli. Rugani has a rest. And it's a three-man defence. Nick Steiner and Asamoah push up into midfield alongside Pjanic and Khedira, with Mandzukic and Dybala flanking Gonzalo Higuain in his first start against his former club. Came on as a substitute in the first match. Needed just over a minute to make the impact and score the winning goal. That was on 70 minutes. While for Napoli, they have Reina in goal. Maggio comes in for the suspended Usai. Albiol and Koulibaly recalled. While Strinic completes the back four. Rog, Diawara, Hamsik, Insigne, Callejon and Milik. Have a minute's silence to show respect to Roberto Fiore, former president of Napoli. He passed away yesterday at 92 years of age. So the big news for Napoli is the return of Milik in attack. Last started on the 2nd of October in round 7 at Bergamo. So a full cycle without the pole. From kickoff, supported by Callejon and Insigne. Insigne on fire at the moment. Well, the main talking point is Rock. Just his second start. The first was in Napoli's cup debut against Spezia. Performed well. Different though, stepping up from a Serie B team to the champions. And the match kicks off. Juventus. First challenge. Mandzukic against Callejon. Napoli back to wearing their classic sky blue. Reds in the traditional black and white stripes. Lee Steiner replacing Dani Alves.